Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Marvel Snap on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Marvel Snap and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Marvel Snap. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, the first thing to do is to open our main internet browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to that URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, because there's the link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed right here on our own internet site of Usitility, where we include a precise demonstration on the best way to download Marvel Snap on PC. We scroll down a tad and press on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on this link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we will launch to play Marvel Snap on the PC. As you can see here, we have a great deal of advantages of preferring this emulator. Now we are ready to start downloading the Marvel Snap by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on it. And the download action takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the executable file. Okay, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the system. We have said yes. I minimize the internet browser to start to see the installation software much better. The installer is quite simple. It is made up of two options, install and setup path. I will show you what setup path genuinely does. We simply just click on it. And we observe that we display here the path where in fact the emulator will be placed. If we choose to change for better this folder, we must click on the Browse button, and therefore we pick another folder and set up the emulator specifically where we would like. I prefer to keep it by default. I simply click on Back. And I simply click Install. Now, there it is. The setup commences and it's going to proceed along with the download of those MB that happens to be displayed on the screen. As you save it on your hard disk, it could possibly be more or less MB. The download speed will go faster or slower, based on your type of connection and depending on the performance of the emulator servers. Right away they're working rather fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be started on autopilot. As you can see, down here, we have a progress bar which will fill up then when it attains the ending, the emulator is launched for the first time. In fact, the emulator was already started, here for the first time. Before we continue, as you can see now, it created two icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is going to be the one we are interested in. Each time we desire to launch Marvel Snap on the laptop or computer, we double mouse click on this particular icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's perform the next phase, which is actually a must, and which is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can see, the Google Play has started. In this case, we have got to sign in. Now as soon as we're right here, we must conduct this next phase that is definitely mandatory. So we click on, Sign In. Now it shows, Checking Info. It might occasionally get stuck in, Checking Info, additionally it isn't going to continue. If so, you could attempt to connect to your account after a few hours and it will surely quite likely be sorted out. Now we will type our email and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email as well as its corresponding password. For example, you can use the very same email address you use at the moment in your own YouTube account. Therefore, I will provide my data and I will go back when I have completed it. That's it, details typed. Below is Google welcoming us and offering us their twos. We must say yes to them by clicking on, I agree. Next, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You might leave it selected, it's going to generate a backup of the data on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can utilize this feature if you prefer. We just click on accept. Google Play is launched without need to open it manually and on autopilot. To install the video game, we have got to get to the emulator desktop for Android by clicking this icon designated green colored. Now that we are watching the desktop of that Android emulator, we see that we have now right here the install app game option. We just click on the button. Here we get the Android game. How about we click right here on the install link that I'm just presenting now in green. And it will begin the software setup. At this time it will install the Android game, it can take a while or it may be very quick. This all is determined on the internet access. It has just completed installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by pressing the following option that I am showing in green, so that you can use Marvel Snap for the very first time. We are by then on the emulator desktop, and then we are going to simply click that fresh Marvel Snap software icon that has been created. The video game is started for the first time on your device. There we end up with it. I could mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the sound level of this emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we will not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we should turn on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is actually the very first one. We simply click on this app icon which I'm designating in green. And the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. If we wish to play the app in full screen, we hit this particular software icon. And we would likely without a doubt be experiencing the game in 100% screen setting. To stop the complete screen mode, press the F11 key. And we'd just end up being in normal display setting. Now I am starting to explain you the keys mapping which is definitely quite cool. That way we will be able to make use of the video game a lot more effortlessly. The first thing is to mouse click this app icon. It's now time to complete the appropriate configurations. I can put the normal settings, but if you desire to change that, you can easily do it now with no problem. As you can see, the emulator is totally in our own language. In certain cases it happens that your emulator is started in the erroneous language, such as, in Chinese. And to place it in the appropriate language we go there to the cogwheel. And there throughout various other settings, we click the language drop down. We should determine the language we need. English, Chinese, etc. After the language is selected, we could save, the emulator will reboot, and the Android game, the next time we launch it, would of course be in the opted for language. Now, there's another point that we need to take into account, and this is that we will get an email telling you that a new device has been connected to our own Google account. It will certainly question us if we're the individuals who have connected that electronic device. Of course, we should not get worried, simply because the emulator is simulating an Android device. And to discover which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we come right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And we go here to the model selection. And there we see that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for my video tutorial. I hope you appreciated it, specifically that everyone thought it was useful. If so, give it a nice like, subscribe to our channel, and any feedback, questions or ideas, let them in the comment box below. You could even comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams from time to time, you have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click any of the video tutorials that happens to be showing up on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the future videos. Bye.